Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. I'll show you quickly what happened in the previous week around the full moon that was on August 1st and the critical planetary geometry that coincided with the full moon. We didn't have a really big quake. If we look at the SGI graph, magnitude 5.6 and larger, we see a small clustering on the 1st and 2nd of August at the time of the full moon and following the convergence of planetary conjunctions on the 31st, but it wasn't really much. It peaked magnitude 5.7. And then we had the critical geometry with the Moon, Mars and Saturn conjunctions in a very short time. These conjunctions happened on the 3rd and 4th, and we see that there is actually continuation of stronger earthquakes approaching magnitude 6, and it actually peaked magnitude 6.2 deep below Argentina about 2 days after the lunar conjunctions with Mars and Saturn. And then we see a small continuation also of 5.7, 5.8 in Hindu Kush region, which was widely felt. Then later on we see at the South Sandwich Islands a 5.7 and a 5.6. By that time we are at the next planetary conjunction, which I will discuss in a minute. The South Sandwich Islands, they produce a major quake roughly every 2 years, and the last time was in August 2021. So it is possible that we will have a major earthquake there in the short term. Let's get on with the planetary geometry that we're going to have in the coming week. Before I go into that, I will show you the animation that I prepared with the planetary conjunctions. These are 8 planetary conjunctions in the next 3 weeks, and some of them rather critical. Much more critical is the lunar geometry, which I marked in green on the right side. And especially the lunar geometry with Mars and Neptune, there will be right angle geometry in an opposite fashion, and there will only be about 4 hours in between. This geometry is really critical. I'll show you a few examples before I go into the animation. Let me show you what happened in 2012 when Earth was also almost exactly between Mars and Neptune. That was on April 9th, 2012, and 2 days later we had a magnitude 8.6 and also an 8.2 within a few hours off the coast of northern Sumatra. There was no planetary geometry, other planetary geometry involved. It was just this geometry of the Earth, Mars and Neptune and the critical lunar geometry right there. We go further back in time, 1957, in February, we also see Earth very close to Mars and Neptune. And that also allowed for very critical geometry, again, right angle geometry in an opposite fashion. And if that happens in a short time, we can have really large seismic activity. In this particular case, it took another 4 weeks on 9 March 1957 for a magnitude 8.6 to occur at the Aleutian Islands. But this is the kind of geometry that can produce really big quakes, around 8.5 magnitude. Now, let's go back to the current situation. If I show you the animation here, we have Venus, Mercury, Mars. That happened this morning. This is a critical conjunction. And then we have Mercury, Venus, Neptune associated with major to great seismic activity around 7.8 to 8 magnitude. Then we have the Sun, Venus, Earth on the 13th, followed by Mars, Venus, Neptune. Again, a critical conjunction. And these planetary conjunctions, they occur in a short time, as you can see, because we have Mars, Mercury, Venus, Earth and Neptune almost in a conjunction here. But it is not really an exact conjunction. The planetary conjunctions occur spread out over several days in the next 2 weeks or so. So then we have Mars, Mercury, Neptune, and that will happen on the 19th. Also a critical conjunction because Mercury is in between Mars and Neptune. And at the same time, we have this critical lunar geometry. If we talk about the 19th, we look at the lunar geometry and we see that on the 19th also, the Moon will make conjunctions with Mars and Neptune. And that happens within about 5 hours. This is really critical because we also have the planetary conjunction converging at the same time. And then we have Sun, Venus, Saturn on the 21st, followed by Mars, Earth, Neptune. There we have the exact conjunction with Earth between Mars and Neptune. That is on the 22nd. And we see that it is followed 4 days later by right angle geometry. lunar geometry with Mars and Neptune as well. So have an earthquake plan, because we can have some big seismic activity in the next 3 weeks. My estimate is that it will happen it will be in the last 2 weeks of August, most likely. But as we've seen in 1957, it can take another 4 weeks for the largest seismic activity to occur. Nevertheless, you really should consider this planetary geometry and also the lunar geometry, in particular with Mars and Neptune. It can be really critical. And I suspect, in combination with the planetary conjunctions that we have in converging with the lunar geometry, we should really anticipate some big seismic activity in the next 3 weeks. Let's have a look at the SGI graph. The next week or so, we have purple peaks, Venus really prominent here, planetary conjunctions with Venus. It starts early this morning with Venus, Mercury, Mars at midnight, and it is followed shortly after by a lunar conjunction with Jupiter. Then we have Mercury, Venus, Neptune, and that will be on the 11th, as we have seen in the animation. And at the same time, we have some lunar geometry there with Mars and with Neptune. There are several hours in between there, about 15 hours. But as we've seen later on in the month, it will be within 4 hours. And as with less time, it is more critical, it's more powerful. Then we have a Sun-Venus-Earth conjunction on the 13th, and then also on the 15th, 16th, that is actually around midnight on 16th, Mars-Venus-Neptune. This is the planetary and lunar geometry it will have. And pay attention, with the Mars-Neptune geometry with the Moon will be extremely critical. Maybe not right away, but we have the planetary conjunctions here, especially Venus, Mercury, Mars, and also Mercury, Venus, Neptune. These are the two really critical planetary conjunctions that we have today and also on the 11th. And then it sets in with the critical lunar geometry, really is going to be critical, especially in the last 2 weeks of August. Check out the website for the latest updates. Also, the atmospheric fluctuations, they can be a significant indicator where larger seismic activity may occur. Check out the website regularly. Have an earthquake plan, because it is going to be critical this month. Be on watch. This is the update so far. Stay safe. Until next time.